Hey, what's up? It's Kelly Berglund, and I am hanging out with Rob at Front Row Live.
As I mentioned earlier, over the years, I've been watching you on Disney Channel with my little brother.
That's amazing.
But now, this is crazy, right? So now you're transitioning from the Disney world. You're doing your first horror film. What is that transition like for you?
It's really interesting. I've always wanted to do like a horror film. And the director always says it's not a horror film. It's like a supernatural thriller. There are scary elements to it. And those are actually like my favorite types of scary movies. It's like the supernatural stuff. I don't like just, you know, blood and
crazy
guts.
Yeah.
Like Saw. Like, I'm not about that.
You'll be there soon.
Oh, no. But it's been really cool. I actually was working on it for a little bit before rehearsals for this. And then right after this, I go back to New York to finish it up. So it's like, it's kind of weird that this was like plopped right in the middle of it. Like such a 180 from like doing something like this, even like from Lab Rats to doing that is like such a transition. But it's cool. My character is like the lead in the film. And I think for the audience who has enjoyed Lab Rats for so many years and are still young, it's not going to be a crazy shocker type of character that I'm playing. I think the film itself is, there are elements that are very freaky. So go into that knowing that. But my character, I think it makes sense. It's not a total just like, why would she do a role like that? Because she's grounded and she's the girl that is kind of like, what's going on? And she's not the one that's like the crazy one or anything like that.
Right.
So I think the role is still, it's just a more adult role. And as I get older and as the fans get older, we will all grow together. And hopefully they'll enjoy the projects I'm doing. And this is, you know, if you're open to it, I understand people, not everyone likes scary movies.
I agree. Yeah, yeah.
But if you're open to that sort of thing, I think you'll like the film, and hopefully my character won't be too much of like a shocker.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Now, for you personally, like, what is it like to go from being in a Disney world all the time to, because this film, it's not a Disney film. It's like a more, more mainstream kind of, not that Disney isn't mainstream, but it's like more to the
different
world. Yeah. So does that make you nervous at all?
Nervous? No. Excited, yes. It is something new for me, new for the people who are going to watch it that have never seen me in anything like this. But after coming off of Disney, I want to do roles that make sense and roles that I like, which I very much so enjoy this role. And like I said before, it's a transition that, you know, you can't pick the roles. I mean, unless you're some huge star and you get to read any script you want and be like, I want to do that one. Like, you know, we're in the process where you can't just pick and choose what roles you want to do that would fit perfectly with your career. It has to mold to whatever is happening and what comes your way, but still loving what you're doing. I mean, I don't want to just take a job to take a job. I always keep my audience in mind with projects that I'm doing because I am loyal to my fan base, and it's because of them that the show is so successful. Like, I owe a lot to them, and I appreciate it. So hopefully, you know, you can't please everyone, but
but you have to please yourself as well, so it can't always be about the audience.
And I still think being on Disney, you know what you're getting yourself into, and I hope that, because I know this, a lot of other people who have gone through Disney Channel understand that that comes with it, and you're always going to have those fans. And I know, like, they might be young, but you always have to keep them in mind a little bit.
Right.
At least I do. Again, I don't know. Like, this is just my thought on the whole thing. But I'm excited to break out of that mold and to expand my own horizons in terms of acting, because there's some stuff where I'm running through the woods and freaking out, and like, that was weird. Like, that was
that
so different
so cool,
for
though.
Me to do.
Yeah.
But with what I want to do with my career, hopefully for many, many years, I want to start now by doing different things, hence the reason I'm even doing this project, Beauty and the Beast, because I'm stepping outside of my comfort zone and doing stage. So I'm taking this opportunity now while I've just come off of Disney to just really expand.
Right. And I think that's just going to make you a better performer in the long run.
Exactly. You take, even though, you know, this and the horror film are completely different, there are things that I've learned on one set that I can apply to another set in terms of the way I work or the way the lines are set or the way you interact with people. That's the thing, is like, I like to take all of my jobs that I do and apply them to everything I do moving forward, even if they're totally different projects.